उगलता गगन घन अंधकार खो रहा दिशा का ज्ञान स्तब्ध है पवन चार अप्रतिहद गरज रहा पीछे अम्बुधि विशाल भूधर जो ध्यान मग्न केवल जलती मशाल।
दिस इज अयोध्या'स गुप्तार घाट। द मोमेंट लॉर्ड राम्स बेबी फीट टच द ग्राउंड हियर द अर्थ गेट्स ब्लेस्ड। Lord Ram returns to his abode by Kunt through this very Guptar Ghat after cleansing the earth of its sins. He leaves behind a global world of such spiritual and human values that it becomes a subject of research. When the Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan ventures to understand the Ram-infused world through research, then layer after layer, new points emerge. Situated on the banks of the Saryu River in Faizabad district of Uttar Pradesh, Ram's Ayodhya writes the definition of affection in the animate and also the inanimate. Ayodhya and Lord Ram are synonymous. In this synonym are inherent innumerable secrets. Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan searches for them, gives them words, records them, etches them on canvas and brings them to life on stage. The Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan was established by the Sanskrit Department of Uttar Pradesh Government at the Tulsi Smarak Bhavan on August 18, 1986. The Tulsi Smarak Bhavan in Ayodhya was constructed by the UP government on the demand of seers and sadhus in 1969. To cherish his memory, a life-size statue of Goswami Tulsidas in Ramayana writing posture is installed in this Tulsi Smarak Bhavan. Since its inception, the Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan has kept a serious approach towards its objectives. The result of this was that whether it was research or publication, art or production, global pervasiveness of Lord Ram, or effort to scientifically prove Ramcharitmanas, new milestones were created daily. The manner in which Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan has collected and preserved the art, culture, literature, popular literature, history, especially of Ayodhya, is remarkable. Lord Ram's global pervasiveness and acceptance is also because he is not linked with any one religion. Ayodhya has a secular character. Ayodhya is also the birthplace of Jainism. From the first Tirthankar to the fifth were born here. Lord Buddha also resided in Ayodhya for several days. Buddhist texts have termed it as Vishala. The Dargah of the Prophet Sheesh and the tomb of Baribua are also located here. Mahatma Buddha and Mahavir were born in the Ikshvaku clan of Lord Ram, the first historical representative of human values and the king of Ayodhya. In his autobiography, Vachitra Natak, Guru Gobind Singh Ji has written that Lord Ram's son Love was related to the Bedi clan and Guru Nanak Ji, while Kush was related to the Sodhi clan and Guru Ramdas. Ayodhya has been the center of all religions. The Satyar temple is also an example of this. There is no better place to see Lord Ram's global appeal than Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan. The Ram Katha Museum, which has been set up here with the cooperation of handicrafts Development Commissioner, Government of India is unique. Artifacts of all these forms are collected here. Main among these are terracotta, wood, textiles, metal, leather, paper mache, marble and stone. Ram Katha finds expression in all these art forms. When we look at the states through these handicrafts, then whether they are from the bordering Bihar or Tamil Nadu in extreme south, Ram Katha is present in all of them. The handicrafts which are here from Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Orissa, Karnataka, Andhra, Kerala, Gujarat, Maharashtra etc. reveal a lot about Ram Katha without saying much. These handicrafts provide jobs to lakhs of craftsmen even today. These art forms getting a special epic landscape also adds to their elegance. That is why this art becomes acceptable and better than the modern arts of the world. Edward Vivechini Sabha had identified 148 places while listing many historical and religious places of Ayodhya and Faizabad. These places were given serial numbers. The first stone was placed at Ram Janmabhoomi. Over time, all these serial number bearing stones disappeared, out of which Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan has searched out and secured 90 stones. Besides this, with its limited resources, Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan has given place also to handicrafts from foreign countries. Another important object of Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan is research work, survey and publication. The intensity with which the Sansthan has executed this has earned it international recognition. Sansthan has now published 115 research texts. Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan's research and survey tells how Ram's journey was not just from Ayodhya to Lanka, but how it became global. Some researches are amazing. For example, cultural relations between Ayodhya and Gimahe, that is South Korea, Raghuvira, a global journey of Ramayana, perspective of the Ramayana in India and Southeast Asia, the cultural linkage between Ayodhya, India and Ayutthaya, Thailand. Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan's works and publications on Ram Leelas also are unparalleled. Some of these books like Jaswant Nagar Va Itawa Ki Maidani Ram Leela, Konch Ki Ram Leela, Kashi Ki Ram Leela Ek Album, Ayodhya Evam Nikat Varti Kshetru Me Lok Natya Natkaura. Besides these, Ram Sahitya Kosh, Ram Katha in Indian languages like Avadhi, Pahari, Bangla, Kannar, Gujarati and Tamil are a result of intensive and serious research. Some other books like Sri Ramcharit Manas Ki Vaigyanik Tika, Valmiki Ki Paryavaran Chetna, Faizabad Sanskritik Gazetteer, Sheher Nama Faizabad and Dusra Lucknow, Awadh Sanskriti Vishwakosh, Ram Sahitya Kosh, Ramcharit Manas Ke Rachna Shilp Ka Vishleshan, Ram Kala Sandarb, Ayodhya Kendrit Ram Bhakti Dhara Ka Sangeet Paksh, Shri Ram Bhakti Andolan, Madhya Yugin Uttar Bharat Me Ram Katha Chitravali, Desh Ki Paramparik Lok Chitra Shailiyo Me Ram Katha are amazing, unrivaled, unimaginable publications full of knowledge. Korea's Queen Suvarn Ratna, that queen whose ties with Ayodhya and the secret of Matsya Yugma, pair of fish, also were revealed only after Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan's research. After comprehensive research on the pair of fish, Matsya Yugma, researchers found that fish has been used as insignia on the flags of Germany, Afghanistan, Pakistan, and India's Pandya states, that is, southern India. But the most ancient recognition of the pair of fish is from Ayodhya. The fish pair is found on all the monuments of Ayodhya. When the capital of Awadh shifted from Faizabad, the fish pair symbol came to Lucknow and later became the state symbol. Ayodhya-Korea ties are also linked to the pair of fish symbol. More than about 2000 years ago, Queen Suvarnaratna, that is Queen Ho, went from Ayodhya to Korea. A theme park is proposed to be built by Korea in Ayodhya at a cost of Rs. 50 crores. The role of Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan in establishing the Korea-Ayodhya links has been huge. Not just in Uttar Pradesh, but in the whole of India, Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan is the first among government publications to successfully experiment with public-private partnership in getting books published by commercial and prestigious publication houses, so that books are easily available to the general public. Sansthan's magazine Sakshi is the best way to understand its functioning and many research manuscripts.
Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan is roop mein bahut mahatvapurna hai ki pure Bharatvarsh mein kisi sthan vishesh par adharit Sanskriti vibhag ka koi shodh sansthan nahi hai. संस्कृति विभाग में अयोध्या शोध संस्थान की स्थापना के साथ जो हमें उद्देश्य निर्धारित किए गए उसमें शोध सर्वेक्षण प्रकाशन प्रदर्शन आदि बहुत महत्वपूर्ण रहे. सर्वे के रूप में हम लोगों ने जो सबसे बड़ी योजना संचालित की है वह है रामायण की वैश्विक यात्रा. तो भविष्य में हमारा लगभग 150 देशों में एक रामलीला का जो ये विस्तार है राम जी का, उसके माध्यम से भारत और उत्तर प्रदेश और अयोध्या एक सांस्कृतिक रूप से जुड़ेगा. एक बड़ा रोचक विषय है अयोध्या कोरिया का. 2000 वर्ष की यहाँ की जो राजकुमारी के जाने की यात्रा जो कोरिया की है उस पर भी हम लोगों ने कई किताबें प्रकाशित की हैं. तो अयोध्या शोध संस्थान का जो उद्देश्य है वह संस्कृति के साथ साथ समन्वय स्थापित करते हुए अन्य देशों से हमारा संबंध. अयोध्या शोध संस्थान की कार्य योजना में एक अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण कार्य योजना है हस्तशिल्प में रामकथा. भारत सरकार के विकास आयुक्त हस्तशिल्प के माध्यम से 2012 में इस योजना को शुरू किया गया, जिसमें सभी प्रदेशों के और विदेशों में हस्तशिल्पों का संग्रह किया गया. बच्चों में विरासत के रूप में हमने एक लोकधारा की योजना यहाँ संचालित की. लोकधारा में प्रदेश के लोक नृत्यों को और अन्य प्रदेशों के लोक नृत्यों लोक गायन को हम नई पीढ़ी में 15 से 21 दिन की ट्रेनिंग देकर उन्हें सार्वजनिक रूप से स्टेडियम में प्रस्तुत करते हैं. पता है कि अब तक लगभग 1.25 लाख लड़कों को हम लोगों ने अपनी लोकधारा के माध्यम से अपनी विरासत से परिचय कराया. इसी रामलीलाओं की प्रस्तुतियां दूसरे देशों में होने से भारत के सांस्कृतिक संबंध और वहां के लोगों से जो हमारे 200 साल पहले हमारे भाई गिरमिटिया रूप में गए हैं उनसे जुड़ने का एक बहुत बड़ा अवसर मिलेगा. अवध अवधी तुलसी और रामलीला रामकथा इन उद्देश्यों की पूर्ति के लिए हम सतत प्रयासरत हैं.
इमेजिन इफ दिस जॉय ऑफ रामलीला कीप्स कमिंग टू यू unceasingly for 13 years, starting from 19th May 2004 to November 23, 2015, staging Ram Leela without a break. This record also in the name of Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan. Along with traditional Ram Leelas of different parts of the country, Ram Leelas of foreign countries have also been regularly staged here. As Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan's research tracking Ram's footprints moves forward, it is found that Ram, Ram's story and its staging traverses via Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand, Cambodia, Singapore, China, Japan, Korea, Pakistan, Afghanistan, England, France, Belgium, Italy, and reaches Trinidad, Tobago, Suriname, Fiji, Mauritius, and goes right up to Australia and New Zealand. Inviting artists from abroad to India, stage their Ramlilas, training them, organizing Mahotsav and seminars at the national level, itself go to abroad and stage the traditional Ramlila of our country, Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan makes available opportunities to Ramlila artists coming from different parts of the country. This is the list of all the initiatives which have given international recognition to Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan. A PowerPoint presentation on the scientific aspects in Ramcharitmanas, its relevance to the young generation, in one seminar won applause. Later, the Sansthan published it. The Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan is giving shape to another important objective, and that is to connect the young generation with the ideals of Lord Ram, or keep them connected with our culture. Towards this end, it organizes art camps from time to time, in which a large number of youth and artists are invited. Watching them is an enjoyable experience. Main among them are Ram Katha in Pinjore paintings, Chariot paintings of artists from Andhra Pradesh, Kolkata artists' creation of Vishnu on bed, Ram Katha on tussar paper, and Kohba paintings. Most interesting are the masks of Hanuman as worshipped in different countries. Paintings of Hungary's Miss Rosalia, based on the seven chapters of Ramcharitmanas. Characters of puppet Ramlila by Indonesia's artists and their masks. Ram's court in terracotta and Ram Katha on leather is amazing. It has been drawn in such a way that they look the same on the reverse as they appear in front. Metal handicraft of Chhattisgarh and wooden craft of Banaras. Also, the tiara worn during Ramlila are all preserved in the Sansthan. Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan does not stop here. It also gives scholarships, stipends and prizes to research students and writers. Not only this, it also operates job-oriented schemes. It also shoulders the responsibility of operating various craft developmental schemes of Government of India's Textile Ministry and the state government. It also gives fellowships to students doing research on Ram Katha, Ram Leela, Tulsi, Ayodhya and Awadh. The Sansthan is also in the process of implementing a Manas-based diploma program after getting it approved. These diploma programs have been designed on the basis of scholars, specialists of biology, physics, chemistry, environmental science citing scientific inventions from Ramcharitmanas. The important point is that this has been implemented in the Bhoj Open University of Madhya Pradesh. It has also been implemented in the Sir Sundar Lal Sharma Open University of Chhattisgarh. Where there is Ram, celebration is bound to be there.
Ram Rajya ki sthapna aur wo Ram Rajya ki paribhasha kya hai ke Prabhu pure janmanas mein प्रत्येक व्यक्ति के मन मानस में प्रत्येक व्यक्ति के हृदय रूपी सिंहासन पर बैठने के लिए ललायत थे और यही रामराज्य की व्याख्या है। राम राज्य का प्रथम सूत्र है, नहीं दरिद्र को दुखी न दीना, यही दरिद्रता के साथ दीनता को मिटाना, यही राम राज्य का दर्शन, यही 14 वर्ष की भगवान श्री राम की जो यात्रा है, ये राम राज्य की स्थापना की यात्रा है।
अयोध्या बीइंग द सिटी ऑफ लॉर्ड राम, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग स्पेशल सेलिब्रेशंस हियर इज ओनली नेचुरल। Every year, four fairs are held in Ayodhya, in which lakhs of devout take part. Main among these are the Magh Mela in January-February, Ram Navami Mela in March-April, Savan Jula in July-August, Kartik Mela and Ram Vivan Mahotsav in October-November. How can our folk arts and folk culture is promoted and conserved in the midst of the blind race for Western culture? The Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan's efforts in this direction have proved to be a milestone. The Sansthan itself does not find its attempts so far to understand and explain Ram as sufficient, because every research leads to a new one. Ayodhya and Ram have a cultural spread of world level, and the manner in which rich traditions are mingling, will it be possible to have matching publications? Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan considers that to be a challenge. Through Ramayana's global journey, Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan dreams of global expansion of Ayodhya and Ram Katha and establishing a Ramayana Center. Ayodhya Shodh Sansthan is a part of Cultural Affairs Department. So, it is the responsibility of the department to present the different cultural aspects of Ram.
Hogi Jai, Hogi Jai, He Purushottam Naveen, Kehe Mahashakti Ram Ke Badan